these two teams from yesterday on the motion of changing speaker, and the majority is two teams which actually show the government is unstable, and this will actually be hard for the government to function, especially during budgeting tabling session, which involve a lot of voting, and to a certain extent, like, which means all the minister, including PM and everyone, need to be in the parliament for the voting. So he was suggesting that the best way is actually to dissolve the parliament and get a new mandate. How do you see this?
Obviously, everyone knows the numbers now. Yeah, it's very clear what the numbers are. 113, 109. There's no denying that. The result was 111, 109. Max was not well, and Rashid was chairing. Their votes are with us. So it's 113, 109. No more debate about the numbers. That's a small majority. That's a very small majority. You're talking about a majority of two from 111, which is half of 222. Obviously, this makes things challenging for the government. Our attendance in Parliament will be will be compulsory. We'll have to be here most of the time, terutamanya apabila berlaku undian, untuk memastikan bahawa segala rang undang-undang dapat diluluskan, terutamanya apabila sampai ke peringkat belanjawan. We must make sure that we can't even go to the toilet when voting takes place, because we might lose a bill. So, in a sense, Shabri is right. It makes governing a little bit more difficult. Is it impossible? No, it's not impossible. Of course, it's possible. We've already been tasked, ministers and deputy ministers, on when, on our days that we have to monitor in Parliament. Of course, most of us are around this area. Tetapi ada hari yang kita compulsory attendance in the Dewan. As ministers and deputy ministers, kita dah susun jadual kita. So I feel that we are prepared in terms of attendance in Parliament. And I feel that we can conduct the business of government even with a slim majority. We can pass laws, we can still command a majority in Parliament, we can still carry out policies, the Cabinet can still function. I feel that it is important that we overcome this phase of economic recovery before we even consider elections. This is a crucial part of the pandemic recovery, because it's to ensure that there are no new waves of infection. We've successfully brought down the infection curve. Active cases are down to 60 plus. We want to make sure that unlike other countries and cities, there isn't a new wave or cluster of infections. And most crucially, we want to make sure that economic recovery is underway. We know that the loan moratorium will expire in September. We're looking, and the Ministry of Finance is still discussing with the banks what to do with that. But we know that once the loan moratorium expires, economic, there will be more challenges as far as the economy is concerned. So it's very crucial that the next few months we can continue to govern. And as I said, even with a small majority, it is possible to govern. Now, in the long term, economic recovery, it's important to stabilize the next few months to ensure that we have a strong recovery. But recovery will take more than just a few months. It will take maybe a year, maybe a year and a half. That requires a stronger mandate and a more stable government. Now, of course, the timing of the elections is entirely at the discretion of the Prime Minister. But I think, as a member of the administration, I feel that once we've overcome this initial part of recovery, however long that is, a few months or maybe just under a year, we should look at a renewed mandate, because a stronger recovery for the economy will require a much more stable government. So the message today is, we can govern. It's not a problem to govern with a majority of two. I feel that we can still conduct the business of government. We need to focus on immediate recovery and prepare for the budget in November and the 12th Malaysia Plan in January. But I think in the medium term, it's always good to have a stronger mandate.
Terima kasih bersama Bro Jingo Channel. Mohon subscribe channel ini bagi mengikuti video menarik di masa akan datang. Jika anda menyukai berita ini, mohon like dan share sebagai tanda sokongan anda. Sokongan anda amat dihargai. Terima kasih.